Hi, welcome. Let me introduce my esteemed panelists. First off, we have Eliza Jacobs, who is the Director of Consumer Insights and Analysis at PBS. She manages the primary research and consumer insights as part of PBS's business. And then we have Raj Manocha, who is the CEO of Methodify by Delvina, and he is here to talk about his research automation platform. So thank you both for coming. Looking forward to having this chat. And let's kick it off with Eliza talking a bit about what brought PBS to Methodify.
Thanks, Brecky. Raj and I go way back to the first week of March 2020 at the last, I think, in-person event we all attended at the Quirks event in Brooklyn. And I saw a very quick demo of Methodify's platform. I really liked it. I saw it was quick, had a lot of really cool, interesting automation built in, and I kept it on our radar as a tool that I thought we would want to experiment with at some point once I found a good use case. And Raj and his crew were very patient with me for the rest of 2020, and then we finally found a really good use case to test some creative assets in support of Ken Burns' next documentary, which premieres on PBS this fall, about Muhammad Ali.
Awesome. And before you went to Methodify, talk a little bit about how PBS did its consumer insights. Talk about your insights community at PBS.
Sure. Yeah. So we, up until recently, did have our own proprietary research, community insights community. And it was a great resource, right? We could tap into it at any time. We had really cultivated that community. That is no longer a resource that we have at PBS. So this has been a big paradigm shift for us for how we do research, and that we're now without that community. And I will say that that community, the demographics, because of how people were recruited in, tended to sort of skew more like our PBS's traditional linear TV viewer, which is more female, more Caucasian, older. And so obviously that is not necessarily representative of all of the people that we reach, nor all the people that we really want to reach. And so now that I no longer have that community, in a way, I feel that I have a lot more flexibility than I have in the past to experiment with different platforms and research partners depending on the project. And so one of the things that I like about Methodify is that it is subscription free. So I can do one project with them, or I can do 25. And it just does, it offers some freedom that I think we haven't previously had. Another thing that's great about it is that there are sort of templated surveys built in for whether it's a concept test or an idea screen or some video response options. And so what's nice is that they're built in and they're templated, which saves me time as a researcher, but there is also flexibility in there in that I can add in custom attributes. I can figure out and work with them to see what test is going to be best for what I need to do, for whether it's testing key art creative, which we're going to talk about, or whether it's videos, or whether it's a title test, which I actually did is just recently did another study with Methodify, testing a few different titles for a new series that will premiere next year at some point.
Amazing. So, tell me a little bit about how you went about selecting the images to test for Ken Burns's Muhammad Ali.
Sure. So yeah, we just saw the one that actually was the chosen one, and will be. This is the yeah. So this is the image you will see in any of the print promotional efforts in support of this film. This is also what will be, a web banner or any sort of digital asset, right? This is the key image we're going to use. So we tested four images, and our creative services team in-house at PBS, they created these images. Worked with our marketing people, also worked with Ken and his team to sort of find the images that, different ones to test. And the four that we tested were very different. They felt very different. I think in some ways they all could have worked. But we're trying to find the one that would work best across a variety of different targets or audience segments. The one that would appeal to both our core audience, but also younger audiences or more diverse, however you want to define that. And so it was interesting because, as I said, they could have all worked, but the one that was chosen sort of was just above, you know, when we did the study, looking at the results, was just a little bit ahead of a couple others, and they had very different fields. I think the other thing we wanted to convey is that this is not just a film about boxing, because there are people that feel very strongly about boxing, don't like it, and maybe, you know, if it's just about boxing, or they think it's just about boxing, they might not watch. Or there are people that also feel very strongly about Muhammad Ali. So trying to, at least in an image, demonstrate how multifaceted, you know, he was and how complex he was. And finally, the other thing is that I will say we have our own biases because we work every day at PBS and we think we know what works and then we know what we like. So, you know, there was a lot of debate internally about those and people felt very strongly about each of the images. But, you know, when it came down to it, I think this is where it's really important to get the consumer's voice, because sometimes you think you know what's going to work, and then the consumer tells you, actually, this is what we think is going to work and what we like best and what will sort of make us want to watch. So, which in the end, that's what we're really trying to do, is get people to watch.
So that's where Raj comes in and Methodify comes in. Raj, why don't you, so tell me, you received these four Ali images and you are tasked with finding the largest cross-section of audience that will expand and not put off existing PBS viewers. Walk us through that process.
Absolutely. I think the producers have an image as well of sort of the way the system works. We can pop that up if it's there. So this is a bit of the reporting, but essentially the way the system works is when you give us the concepts or things like that, we basically upload them to the system. Either we can do that or we can have our client do that. And basically you can start to pick the demographics you actually want to use. So if you wanted to have a cross section of just millennials, we could set that up. If you wanted to have 18 plus, we could set that up. And this is the actual setup screen. Basically, we want to get you in and out in sort of like 10 clicks or less. So set up your title, pick your audience, upload your stimulus. And Eliza sort of talked about the idea of templated methods. And basically, if you don't want to change anything, the method's there for you. So you can kind of do your 10 clicks and away you go. So you can set up your entire project in a couple of minutes. And then all of a sudden that starts to feel, and you start to get people back within the hour. So we even have some clients who basically run this with their marketing group in a whiteboard session within the hour. They're getting data back from the customer segment that they actually want to talk to. So it's a pretty powerful tool. And again, if you don't want to get off the shelf, we absolutely understand that every brand is a bit unique. They might have some sort of change they want to make. So we give the ability to be flexible and customized as well. So adding different question types, attributes, a very custom audience, you name it, we can get it for you. The point is really to take away this idea of this illusion that it's a difficult task to automate. There's a lot of things in the market research process that allows you to become much quicker, especially with the technologies that are available now. But what's more important is, and Eliza sort of touched on this, the biases that end up happening. So this gives you the ability to manage things like exposure, get quick data back. And throughout your process within your journey of sort of idea to market, it allows you to sort of get that data always on. So you can have that customer with you on your journey as you go. And that's a really big important place, because it's never been harder to sort of get customers, never been easier to lose them. So if you want to kind of understand your customer base and sort of how they're interacting with your brand, this becomes a much more powerful tool for a marketer or market research and insights professional to kind of use on an ongoing basis.
Fascinating. How do you take that information and communicate it? We talked about biases and people's opinions and everybody thinks they're right. How do you take that data and basically, is it just, here's the data, move on? Or is there a conversation after you get the results of the research?
It's a great question. So from a pretty experienced researcher, Eliza could kind of get that data back and pick exactly what she wanted to know. For some marketers who use the platform, we actually have a plus service. We actually get a researcher on contract to kind of pretty up a presentation deck or some of the outcomes, so they can have that conversation. So part of this tool as well is how much do you actually want it to do for you? So if you want to do the entire research process and get sort of to that, you know, golden nugget end state of a recommendation, we can provide that service. But a lot of the insights professionals actually just like to get the data back so they can kind of cut the data how they want, look at different pieces, and then make that decision on their own.
And Eliza, on your end, how does that work with you communicating to your team over at PBS?
Sure. I mean, with some projects, it's like, well, here's the data, and I walk through a few things in an email, and that's fine. But with something like this, Ken Burns, and obviously is very high profile, so we'll walk through it together. And I also think in this case, because it was our first foray with Methodify, I wanted to explain sort of what the data are showing, what the charts are showing, because it is a little bit different. I definitely took advantage of the automated reporting because I was like, I love not having to do a PowerPoint from scratch. I can't imagine that anyone enjoys that at this point. So it was really nice to be able to sort of just, you can create any type of report, filter it, and then just export it, and you've got it. If you want to sort of do some aesthetic cleanup, like to the colors or something, you could do that. But what's also interesting in that graph was showing, or Dem had it in there, was that sort of that average benchmark, the 44 across the middle there. And what's also kind of nice is that's an average across a bunch of industries, but that was sort of at least gave some perspective, I think, to help our people understand, like, what does it mean? I mean, obviously I have historical data comparing to previous sort of Ken Burns testing we've done, but that's a nice feature as well. And then another thing is that, and I hope I can say this, I'm going to say it, there's a proprietary insight score that is calculated, at least for the test that I did, the concept test, and it's a sort of weighted score based on a handful of metrics. And I will say that people responded really well to that, and that sort of, I think, helped people wrap their head around the one image being sort of a little bit preferred a little bit more than the others, because that was a weighted metric that combined a couple of attributes and questions, and so people could understand, like, okay, it's not just in isolation this image was, by these questions. It's okay, here are a handful of things, and you weight it, and then that shows you the power of that image or piece of creative or whatever it is.
That's goodness. Okay, so Raj, tell me about how you find this pool of potential audience for PBS. Where are you looking? Where are you finding these folks?
Great question. So we do a lot of different things when it comes to audience. So we have our proprietary sort of groupings that we have. We actually partner also with about 100 online sample providers. So whether it's global, local, US, Canada, anywhere you kind of want to get data, we have a partnership or we have something proprietary. But we also actually work with client lists. So if you want to kind of go specifically with your own list, we can actually do that as well. So this idea is either you want to get a large swath of people who are in your demo, so then we would go to something general, like an online panel. If you want to go more specific to your list, we can do that as well. But based on the type of research you want to do is what we would recommend for the ask. So in this case, Eliza wanted to kind of really understand sort of how this was going to fit. So to her point earlier, it wouldn't make sense to go to the list because you're also trying to get new viewers and trying to understand sort of the differences in those types of things. Whereas if it was something very specific about a thing you wanted to do or a product that you have that was specific to your customer base and that's it, then maybe that's where the client list works. So we basically help to recommend some of those things, but also give you the option to kind of choose on your own as well.
That's amazing. I appreciate both of you taking the time to talk to us about this this new way of finding and expanding audiences, and I appreciate your insights.